Let me show you a simple animated explainer video scene. Hi, I'm John from ABC Marketing Limited. Today, I want to show you how you can scale up your social media marketing efforts without spending much time. So you can devote more of your attention to manage your business, you free up your time to gain more success, enjoy more leisure, and spend time with your loved ones at home, or just simply relax. Would you believe that I did this entirely in PowerPoint? Yes, if you have Microsoft 365, now you have a new option called Cartoon People that allows you to create your own explainer videos right inside PowerPoint. Let me show you where you can find the option in Microsoft 365. All you need to do is to go to Insert, Pictures, and go to Stock Images. Here you find a new tab called Cartoon People, and this is where you get all the assets to create your own animated explainer videos. You can pick and choose elements to create your own cartoon characters. You have options like half characters, heads, faces, upper body, full body, accessories, decorations, scenes, whatever that you require to create your explainer video, you have them available here under Cartoon People. Let me show you how easy it is for you to create your own custom cartoon character. The first thing I need is a full body. So I click on it and I get a number of options. Let us say I want to pick this character, I check this. Then I go up. I want a head now, so let us go to Heads. And there are quite a few interesting options available. Let us say I want to pick this head. Then I want a face, so let us select Faces. Let us say the character is a bit angry. I can search for the angry expression here. Maybe this one is a good one, and I say Insert. Now I have picked full body, head, and face. So now I can move this a little aside, and then I can move this portion to wherever I want on the face. And once I'm happy with the way the face looks, I can group it by pressing Ctrl G, and then I can place this right on top of this character. And if I think that the size needs to be adjusted, I can hold the Shift button down and increase the size by dragging from the corner. Now this size looks good enough. I can adjust the placement, and now I have a nice character who is angry. Now, once I am happy, I can select everything, press Ctrl G, and I can place it anywhere I want. Now, let us say he is an employee, so we want to create an office scene. So once again, I go to Insert, go to Pictures, Stock Images, and in Cartoon People, I'm going to search for Scenes. So I go here, and I can search for Office, and say Enter. Now I have a whole bunch of options available. Let us say the person works as a mid-level executive, so I'm going to select this scene and say Insert. Now I can send this back by using Send to Back option, and this person is over here and I think that this is way too big. I can always resize this. Now this is a beautiful scene. If I want to have a floor, all I need is to draw a rectangle like this and give it a gray color. So now I have got the floor. Right click and send this to back and give this a light gray color, and go to Shape Outline and say No Outline. Now this looks really perfect. Now let us say I want to give this a three-dimensional look. I can ungroup these elements by going to Convert to Shape option and select all these elements. I don't want the clock to be given a shadow. So I've selected all these elements. I go to Shape Effects, go to Shadow and say Perspective, and we have this shadow called Upper Right. Now this looks like a proper scene with relevant shadows and every character is in place. Now as you could see, by ungrouping the scene, I can pick apart the chair where I want to. I can move the clock where I want to. I can even move laptops. Can you see here? I have total liberty to change the scene to suit my requirement. Now let us say I don't have enough elements available right inside PowerPoint. I can always mix and match elements that I pick up from sites like Pixabay.com. For example, I picked up this element right inside PowerPoint. Now I want to have a natural scenery behind the scene. I don't really have that option available inside Cartoon People. So I go to Pixabay.com, and this is a nice enough scene for me to introduce. So I go to free download and download it as a vector graphic, and I can insert it onto the scene. Now take a look at how the scene transforms itself when I place this house right in this background. Now once I insert the scene, since this is an SVG image, I can always ungroup it so that the background matches this cartoon character, or I can ungroup this and color it to suit the background. Now once you have the visual elements on your scene in place, it is only a matter of adding things and removing them using simple fly-in and fly-out animation. To prove it to you, I'll show you the animations that I added in the example scene. Now all these elements have been introduced in the scene using nothing but a simple fly-in animation. Then I built the next slide and I added a transition so that the scene is pushed to introduce the scene. Here, this is a wipe animation, this is a fade animation, and this guy flies in from outside. Now if I go to the next slide, I have these elements flying out and I have these team members flying in. And in the next scene, to talk about success, I have this confetti and balloons, and this is of course one of the scenes available inside PowerPoint. I have it introduced and then it leaves the scene with a simple float out animation. Once that is done, I have the team members and the chair fly out and we have the sofa fly in. And in the next scene, I have these two characters fly in. And in the final scene, we have these two characters and the sofa fly out and we have this scene fly in. Now you see the clip again. Hi, I'm John from ABC Marketing Limited. Today, I want to show you how you can scale up your social media marketing efforts without spending much time. So you can devote more of your attention to manage your business. You free up your time to gain more success, enjoy more leisure, and spend time with your loved ones at home. Or just simply relax. So did you notice that the animations used are very simple and basic? All the characters that you see in the scene are all taken from inside PowerPoint. So if you too want to create an animated explainer video scene, this is the workflow I recommend. The first thing I want you to do is to write a script that will tell the story very clearly. Once you have the script ready, the second thing is to decide on what are the various elements that you require to visualize your scene. Once you have the elements ready, the third step is to animate them so that you are able to bring in the characters you want and take them out when necessary. And the final step is to add a voiceover so that the story is complete. Of course, you always have the option of recording your voiceover first and then match the scene with the voiceover. So with the new option of cartoon people in Microsoft 365, basic PowerPoint animation, and a good screen recorder, you can create your own animated explainer videos like a pro. So go ahead and explore the option of cartoon people inside PowerPoint and see how you can create your own simple scene and impress your audience in your next video. By the way, if you want to know how to use PowerPoint animation like a pro, we have put together a short playlist of videos that is available right here. All you need to do to improve your PowerPoint skills is to click on the link here and start watching the videos. So go ahead, click on the link and start watching the videos right now.